Hello, my name is Mark Stepp. I'm the Chief Innovation Officer here at Realvolve. Wanted to welcome you to this quick overview of the Realvolve CRM. A Customer Relationship Manager, or CRM, is the most important software a real estate agent needs in order to operate efficiently. It's fundamental to building a business that lasts. The challenge is that CRMs built for the real estate industry have become dated, bloated, and ultimately missing the core objective: building a true business so that you can have time for life. Now, we set out to build a new type of CRM that is simple to use and intuitive, yet powerful enough to help automate most aspects of your business so that you can focus on what matters most. We've engineered the most revolutionary CRM in the industry, leveraging the science of relationships and the most powerful workflow platform in the real estate industry. We are transforming what a CRM is expected to do. We serve everyone from the beginning agent to some of the top agents in the country doing in excess of $175 million a year, and we look forward to serving you. Now, I want to be open. CRMs take time to set up and learn, but once it clicks, you'll agree that Realvolve is the best CRM in the industry. So kick back and relax, and I'll share some of the main features. We're only going to cover the top 7 features in Realvolve: the dashboard, contacts, properties, transactions, the templates, workflows, and then the calendar. On the left-hand side of the dashboard, you've got quick access to all the centralized data: the contacts, the properties, the transactions and documents, and even the activities. Below that is the recently viewed section, and it allows you to quickly access those people and properties that you recently viewed. Anytime you want to add new properties, people, or transactions, simply click on the plus button. Then our new dashboard shows lots of great information about your data, making sure that you're kept abreast of all the information inside your database. Below that is the section for notes and correspondence, and then a list of activities that you need to do for the day. In the upper left-hand corner, you have the field to search for anything, and I mean anything. Now we'll take a quick tour of the contacts. We've got the list view in the lower left-hand corner. Above that is the filter options to be able to filter your data by tags, categories, record owners, even the missing data or date fields. There's plenty of sort options, a record count, and a button to view your contacts in more detail. On the left-hand side, you can select multiple records for batch processing. You can quickly add notes, tags, or even delete records that are marked, send mass emails, or even export to Google Drive or a CSV file for mail merging. Anytime you get those pesky duplicate records, you have the ability to merge them into one. Now let's take a look at the details of each contact. There's a basic contact summary, a tab section for accessing grouped information. The first tab is our radar tab. It allows you to see the notes and correspondence, start workflows, even those activities that you need to be doing, and be able to assign tags to each contact. We've incorporated a brand new and revolutionary relationship score feature that allows you to see what kind of relationship you have with each contact, looking at activities that you've done with them, emails that you've sent, and the data that you've collected. The contact tab has that important information that you need: the home and work addresses, phone numbers, emails, all social connections, their relationship, their husband, wife information, birthdays, kids' names, the source of that record, who they were referred by, even the last communication and other personal details. The property tab shows you those properties that are linked to this contact as a party member. The transaction tab does the same thing, but for transactions. The showings tab shows those properties that was shown to this buyer and all the comments that he made about the properties. The files tab allow you to store files like PDFs, Excel spreadsheets, and images to that contact. The calendar shows all those appointments and tasks that are associated with this contact. You can view the data in day, week, or month view. All calendar items are also synchronized to Google. The activities list shows all your activities in more of a list format. And the email tab shows you all emails either sent to or received by this contact. You can connect to Gmail or any IMAP server. Now let's take a look at the properties. The screen is laid out with similar filter, sort, and list view features. The property summary and map are located at the top. The listing tab shows listing details such as the square feet, bedrooms, bathrooms, garage information, all the information that you need to know about that property, as well as the important dates that are associated with this property, like list date, expiration date, and much more. The people tab shows those people that are involved within this transaction. A simple drag and drop feature is available so you can move those people into those spots very easily. This allows you to see the sellers, the agents, the referrals, the photographers, even stagers and locksmiths. The marketing tab shows a centralized location of all your marketing information, URLs for your MLS and website, realtor.com or Zillow. All that information can be stored in one place. You can then use that information in your templates to send to your sellers. The Seller Report tab gives you a place to store all the information that you want to send to your seller. On a daily basis, you can enter information in there. And then maybe on a weekly basis, send all those things that you want the seller to know. The Showings tab stores information that you'll need for your showings. The alarm codes, the gate codes, lockbox numbers, things that you can pass on to your other agents as well. Now for the transactions. Once again, we've got the similar layout for the filter, sort, and list views, the transaction summary and map. The transaction tab itself has information about the transaction, all the details, plus the important dates that are involved, the initial contract date, the acceptance date, all those dates that can be used within a workflow as milestone dates. In the transactions, we have a people tab as well, allowing you to store those people that are associated with this transaction, the buyers, the sellers, the listing agents, the selling agents, their title, escrow, lenders, all that information is available in one spot. Want to keep track of how much you're making on each property? Use the commissions tab. It automatically calculates your commissions. The buyer report tab is the same as the seller report tab. It allows you to send information to your buyers about what's happening within that transaction. The templates are used to create predefined layouts of emails and SMS text messages. You can create an unlimited number of templates. They can be used with contacts, properties, and transactions. Templates can be set up for either email or SMS text messages. And most importantly, the ability to add merge fields in the message. This allows you to quickly send information to your buyers, your sellers, anybody that you want to send information to from within a merge field. It can fill in the data from the database. Templates can also include attachments. So simply click on the attachment button and you're good to go. Now for the powerhouse, the workflows. You have the ability to create an unlimited number of workflows. Each workflow can be used with contacts, properties, or transactions. This means you can use them for drip campaigns, for anything during your listing process, or your closing process. We have the ability to use multiple milestone dates. All of those important dates that were in properties and transactions are available. 2 days after list date, 5 days before expiration date, 7 days before close date. Those types of things can be added quickly. Workflows can be set up to be linear or have branching options. So what does that really mean, branching options? Many CRMs have what they call action plans. Action plans are very linear in design. From the time you sign a contract all the way to closing day, there's 5, 6, 10, 20 things that have to be done. And they're done in a very linear manner. And that's great. It reminds you to do things that you need to do. The problem is, most of the time, you don't work linear. And that's where branching options come in. If we take that same scenario where you have the signed contract, then there's a loan approval. You might have two different options. One is good credit, one is bad credit. One is approved and one is denied. Through a linear progress, you could go on to approved. But what if it's been denied? What could you do? What about credit cleanup? The ability to check to see where the FICO score is incorrect. Do they need credit counseling? Or is there just no chance of getting that credit cleaned up? If we continue on after credit cleanup, you can then get loan approval and then closing day. We've reached the same A to G, but we took an alternate path. We branched to a different method. And by doing that, it gives us alternate options. And that's really where the power of workflows comes into play. It helps you get the things done in more consistent manner and being able to get them done quicker. There's several options for setting up workflow activities. You can select the party members that go along with this activity, the lender, the seller, the buyer. You can set up the date calculations, 5 days after list date, 3 days before expiration date. All those different available important dates are available. You can even set up static or merge field checklists. Merge field checklist gives you the ability to have a checklist and be able to fill in values that go directly into the fields in your database. And then each activity can have multiple actions that are applied to it. Adding tags, starting other workflows, sending emails or text messages. As you complete those activities, you have the option of running any of those activity actions. Activity groups give you an easy way to select multiple activities at one time when starting a workflow. And if you work in a team environment, the ability to assign any activity of a workflow to different team members in your group. All the dates for the workflow are calculated and put on your calendar. That information is also automatically synchronized to Google, so you have it in both places. You're able to see all activities and tasks in one section. When completing activities with checklists and actions, you're displayed a pop-up box and gives you the ability to check off those things in your checklist and run any checklist activities that you might want, which gives you the ability to complete multiple actions at one time. There are several customizable widgets that are available on your dashboard to see information about your data. Year-to-date volume and commission, compare sales volume from year-to-date, from year-to-year, a breakout of all your contact sources, a volume and commission pipeline to see how close you are to reaching your goals. Using the relationship score that we talked about earlier on each contact, we can assign an R factor to your entire database. We look at that database and see, do you have a lot of names that are lead generation website names that you really don't have much relationship with? Or do you have a lot of names in there that you've built relationships with over years, you've done lots of business with lots of people, and you have a higher score? That R factor gives you a view of what kind of quality of database do you have. Based off of that R factor, we can then take the number of contacts you have and give you a prediction on how many transactions you should be able to do with this database. Looking at the information on your past average commissions, we can then also give you a prediction on how much revenue should you make. We can also take a cross-section of your aware, know, like, and trust statuses of each of your contacts and also compare that to the suspect, prospect, lead, client, and past client information that we've got on each contact. Cross-referencing those isolates those people that you should probably contact based off of them getting close to a score that would take them to the next level. This is a great way of finding those people that you need to contact next. There's lots more that we can share with you about Realvolve. This is only scratching the surface of what it does, but we wanted to make a quick intro. So I want to thank you for taking the time to look at it. If you have additional questions, visit our website at realvolve.com or send us an email at info@realvolve.com. Have a great day.